In this video, you will see visual illustrations of three types of products: whole numbers times decimals, decimals times decimals, and mixed decimals times mixed decimals. These products can all be found by using just whole numbers before using decimals. A whole number times a decimal, such as 5 times 2700s, can be illustrated by shading blank decimal squares. 5 times 2700s can be thought of as 5 of the 2700s. So let's shade 1 of the 2700s. Then shade another 2700s. And finally a fifth of the 2700s. The total shaded amount is one whole square in 10, 20, 30, 35 hundredths. So 5 times 27 hundredths equals 1 and 35 hundredths. Have students select a decimal square, for example, 35 hundredths, and determine the number of whole squares in parts of a square if they had 7 of these squares. One approach is to multiply by 7. Seven times the 35 parts of the square, 245 parts. Since one whole square has 100 parts, there will be 2 whole squares and 45 parts out of 100. Then ask students to write the decimal for their square and compute 7 times the decimal. For example, 7 times 35 hundredths means 7 of the 35 hundredths. In other words, it's repeated addition. And for multiplying by whole numbers, we know the product is 2 and 45 hundredths. The algorithm for multiplying decimals is similar to the algorithm for multiplying by whole numbers. In this product, 7 times 5 hundredths is 35 hundredths, and 30 hundredths is regrouped as 3 tenths to the tenths column. To illustrate the product 2 tenths times 3 tenths, we will take 2 tenths of the shaded amount of this 3 tenths square. To take 2 tenths of something, we divide it into 10 equal parts and take 2 of those parts. So we will use these 10 equal spaces to divide the shaded amount of this square into 10 equal parts. Here are 2 of these 10 parts, and they contain 6 small 100 squares. So 2 tenths times 3 tenths equals 6 hundredths. Let's look at another example of the product of 2 decimals. This square represents 8 tenths of a floor that has been painted, and a rectangular rug is placed over 3 tenths of the painted region. What part of the total floor is covered by the rug? So we need to find 3 tenths of 8 tenths, that is 3 tenths times 8 tenths. We will divide the 8 tenths, the painted region, into 10 equal parts. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 equal parts, and notice that the rug is 3 of these 10 parts. Also, the small squares on the rug are all hundred squares. So the rug covers 24 hundredths, 3 of 8 rows. And 3 tenths times 8 tenths equals 24 hundredths. This grid has 9 decimal squares. We know from using the number line that each edge of the unit square has a length of 1. And each edge has 10 small lengths of 1/10. So the dimension of this edge of the shaded region is 1 1/3. And the dimension of this edge of the shaded region is 1 7/10. How many whole squares and parts of a square are in this shaded region? We have 2 whole squares. In these 2 regions, we have 7 full columns for 7/10 and 3 full rows for 3/10. And 7/10 and 3/10 is another unit. And we have 7/10 in this region. And this region down here is 3 by 7, 21/100. So we have 2 plus 1 plus 91/100. And this equals 3 91/100 squares. 2 3/10 times 1 7/10 equals 3 91/100 squares. Another method of determining the number of whole squares and parts of a square in the shaded region is to multiply. (23 × 17). Since there are 23 small squares along this edge, and 17 small squares along this edge, and we know this equals 3 91/100 squares, because there are 100 parts in each unit square. The algorithm for multiplying whole numbers shown here, and the algorithm for multiplying decimals are similar. For example, the algorithm for multiplying 2 3/10 times 1 7/10 would look like this. Suppose we had not computed 2 3/10 times 1 7/10 and only needed an approximation. By rounding 2 3/10 to the nearest whole number 2, and rounding 1 7/10 to the nearest whole number 2, the product would be approximated by 4. The grid shows the approximation of 4 is more than the actual product. Rounding 1.7 up to 2 increases the product by this region 6/10. And rounding 2 3/10 down to 2 decreases the product by this region that is less than 6/10. So the increase causes the estimation to be too large. This result from the National Assessment of Educational Progress shows that students aged 13 have difficulty rounding and estimating products of mixed numbers. To the nearest whole number, 3 4/100 rounds to 3, and 5 3/10 rounds to 5. The product of these two numbers is 15, and the closest of the given numbers to 15 is 16. It was selected by only 21% of the students. One implication from these results is that students need more experiences in rounding and estimating. Computing products of decimals by first using whole numbers and models such as decimal squares and grids can help to keep ideas intuitive and meaningful before students start memorizing rules for operations with decimals. We will end this video
with a description of the game Decimal Squares Speedway from decimalsquares.com.
This speedway represents a 10-mile racetrack marked off in tenths of a mile. A player flips a card, spins a spinner, and the car's progress is the product of these numbers. Lewis has a decimal point 3 and spins a spinner and gets a 4. So we multiply 4 times 0.3 Good job. Now it's Jan's turn. She turns over a card and spins a spinner. Now she multiplies 2 times 0.55. That's the correct product. So she advances her car to the 1.1 mark, just a little bit behind Lewis.